Challenge has just come in from Moist Potato.
Jen, I need you to win 3 games in a row with Pink Fury and the Archer class, because that doesn't go together. If you lose, suck on a potato.
After receiving the challenge from Moist Potato, it was time to create the deck. How was I going to be able to win with such a garbage combination of units that were forced upon me? Should I back down? No. Absolutely not. We do not show weakness on this channel. Okay, this is going to be hard. The first 2 minis will be easy. It will be the Princess and the Executioner. The next mini will be the Archer. Now here's where the decisions come in. Do I take the Dark Goblin or the Dagger Thrower? The Dagger Thrower would help me get to a 4 Ranger class faster. However, the Dark Goblin might be able to win versus a Grand Warden and a Shield. Oh, this is so tough. I can't lose. I really don't want to get that close to a potato. Dark Goblin it is. Now, to round out the deck, I'm going to need to have to take Elixir Golem for the extra Elixir synergy with Pink Fury, allowing me to get my carries onto the field fast. All right, here we go. Game number 1. The rules are simple. I have to win all 3 games without losing. If I lose, I have to suck on a potato. I don't even know how that's gonna work, but I do not want to find out. All right, here we go. The first thing I'm gonna have to do is get down the Elixir Golem, which is what I am able to do. That's gonna be huge value in round number 1 for us. It's going to give us Elixir, but guess what? We played a pretty hard counter in round number 1. Hopefully, my Princess can carry me to victory here. And hopefully also my Pink Fury can get some really good value here. And by really good value is I just want to make sure I get at least 2. That's fine. I don't need to win this round. The Princess is going to be my carry in this matchup. I put my Elixir Golem over the tile just to make it very nice and clean. Now we're going to go with a Princess here. We have a ton of Elixir as well. So we're gonna, I probably should have put out my, okay, there it is. Elixir Golem one more time. We got down the Executioner as well. The Executioner with the Princess hopefully will be enough to carry us to victory. This is gonna be looking pretty good here as he did get down a Knight. Gotta be able to clear down the Knight in time. There it is, Knight falls. We're gonna get down some good Princess shots here, and that's gonna be a lot of damage. 2 more Elixir here with my Pink Fury, and we are going to win here in round number 2. All right, now, Dark Goblin is going to be huge here in round number 3. Hopefully we get a very, very good tile for us. There it is. Not a good tile at all whatsoever. We're going to go with the 2 bonus HP for the Pink Fury here because it kind of needs to be my tank. I'm going to put the Dark Goblin here. I don't want... No, the Dark Goblin's going to go in the back. I'm going to reroll. I'm going to go with another Princess. I also want to go with a Dark Goblin with infinite range, and we are going to also ready it up right here. We are just trying to win as best as possible. He's going with the home run onto the Executioner, but guess what? The Executioner is not my carry here. It is going to be my Princess. This has got to be able to win me the round. There it is. Going to be looking pretty good so far. Princess is just supering off. He's getting off a little bit of damage as well here. Got to be able to super on it to the Royal Champion. World Champion falls, and we're going to win in round number 3. All right, this is getting pretty intense because we do need to win this round if we are going to be successful. I actually want to load up the box here with my Executioner. This is going to be the player heard around the world. Executioner is going to get upgraded here. I really don't want to upgrade anything else. Well, it does gain shield. Hold on. We could do damage to shield and block with my Dark Goblin. We're actually going to go with a 3-star Dark Goblin here. We're going to block his Prince. This could be looking very, very nice. He does go invisible with his World Champion, which is going to be huge value for him. But we are just trying to do as much damage as possible to his entire army. We are clearing things out. The Princess still is in the back line. It's still alive. Princess going after him, and that's going to be GG in game number 1. Looking good. All right, game number 2 versus a Wave Master player. Okay, Wave Master. How do I even want to do this? Well, the first thing I got to do is I got it. That's very nice. I'm going to sell this and I'm going to ready it up. I want to put my 3-star Princess onto this invisibility tile, and I want to put my Dark Goblin all the way on the back left, and that's kind of going to be what hopefully wins me the match. That's really all I could hope for right now. Now, we do want to get a little lucky here. No, not going to get anything. We are probably going to get two more extra elixir. Maybe more. Are we going to be able to win this round? This would be huge. This is what we need. We don't want to be under pressure. Oh, come on. If this is the reason why I lose, I swear I will not be happy. Okay. It's fine. Everything is fine. Princess is going to go here. Princess 3-star is the answer. I just know it. That's just what I know. And if I know it, that's it. Princess. God, man. Do I just do this, though? No. You don't do this. I should have went with another elixir golem. This is so tough. I have no idea how to play this deck because it's so bad, but that's okay. We're going to be doing some pretty good work here. This is what we need to figure out how to win. Gonna get some good damage here with my executioner. Executioner is clearing a lot out. We better not lose. I think we win. Now we got this. All right, that's going to be a round two victory. You better believe it. He's already got 4 clan, 2 specialists with this Wave Master. We're going to have to upgrade this. Oh, man. This stinks because... Okay, oh, no. It doesn't really stink that bad. This... Man, this is tough. We're going to ready it up like this. This is looking okay. We do have the invisibility for our archer here. We can also swap that out to Pink Fury as well, which is might be what I am going to be doing in the future here. Princess has got to be able to stack up and got to be able to win this match for me. There's the damage coming off onto his entire army. His entire army falls. Princess still stacks up, still looking very, very good. Princess got to shoot off, and it is. That's going to be a victory here, I believe, in round number 3. All right, this is looking good. You better believe it. All right, so... what do I do here? Match point. This is looking okay. I do want to go with a 3-star archer here. Do I go with a 3-star princess? Princess is my hard carry, so we are going to upgrade that. I also want to upgrade... we're going to upgrade the executioner with the 3-star... and we're going to give myself some bonus HP onto the Elixir Golem. I'm also going to get bonus HP onto my Pink Fury as well. Big beefy boy with our Elixir Golem here. Got to shoot off. Got to be able to do more damage. Doing a ton of damage. This is going to be a lot of damage. Going to eliminate the P.E.K.K.A. There it is. Look at this beautiful play from Enchantin. As this is going to be a Game 2 victory. We're looking good. All right, game number 3 versus another royal champion. All right, this is going to be fine. Everything is going to be fine. Nice, we got another elixir golem. If there's one chance we have of winning, it's getting an elixir golem in round number 1. Absolute huge value right there for us. This is looking good. Moist Potatoes Challenge. Well, it's looking good, but anything could happen, especially with a royal champion. The royal champion just stays in the back line for a lot of time, but we might be able to win this in round number 1. Oh, this is going to be looking good. Come on. Ah! All right, that's fine. Was that really loud? That was, I don't know how, what sound that was, but that was a loud sound that I just made. All right, so we're gonna continue it off here. This is the juice, though, that I really like. I really like this. Princess has gotta be my carry in chat. Princess is your carry. Remember. Okay, this is fine. Princess has long range. All right, so we got the princess, we got the executioner, we got a lot of elixir here. We've used that elixir in this round. We're going to try to just use it even more. This is doing a lot of damage to him. Got to get down my executioner. There it is, a lot of damage. He was not anticipating an executioner and a princess. Who really is? I mean, come on now. He does get only 1 stack with his royal champion, but that's not going to matter. All right, Enchantin, come on. You can do this. This challenge is easy. All right, it's not really easy, though, because this is a rough. This is a rough one. What do I do? Do I go with 3-stars? Yes, I do. Okay, so this is fine. Maybe he has... we're going to block that, and we're going to block this. This is what we're going to do here. We're going to be making sure our carries are perfectly... No, I don't want to do this. I want to do that. Because if he has a Prince, we could put the Pink Fury to block the Prince on the Executioner's side. That's what we could do if that's his last mini. It is not his last mini. He's going to show his last mini to be a Musketeer. We're looking really, really good here. Got to be doing more damage with my Executioner. Going to be doing a lot to win just like that. It's over. Oh, wait, no, it's not over. Oh, we jumped the gun. We jumped it. It's all right. It ain't over yet. We're going to add an upgrade over there. We're going to get down our... Ooh, we're going to get down our Princess. Princess is going to get upgraded here to do more damage. This is just all looking good to... Well, we're just going to ready it up here. This should be okay. He says it's not over yet. Is it going to be over, though? That's the question. Princess does a lot of damage. Princess, trying to pick up value like you better believe. Not being able to clear it or anything, but there's a lot of damage right through his backline. Where it is? Later, it's over. Moist Potato, where you at? Easy. Who's coming at me next with the next challenge?